the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be
with you. And with your spirit.
Good morning. We gather together as God's people this day. We gather to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Our Mass today is offered for Justin Whitehead, whose second anniversary it is today. We keep Justin and his family in our prayers at this time. Lord Jesus, you are Prince of Peace. Lord, help us.
Lord, help us.
Lord Jesus, you lead us to the Father, Christ, help us.
Christ, help us.
Lord Jesus, you plead for us at the right hand of God. Lord, help us.
Lord, help us.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, by whom we are redeemed and receive adoption, look graciously upon your beloved sons and daughters, that those who believe in Christ may receive true freedom and an everlasting inheritance. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. It makes me happy to suffer for you, as I am suffering now, and in my own body to do what I can do to make up all that still has to be undergone by Christ for the sake of his body, the Church. I became the servant of the Church when God made me responsible for delivering God's message to you, the message which was a mystery hidden for generations and centuries and has now been revealed to his saints. It was God's purpose to reveal it to them and to show all the rich glory of this mystery to pagans. The mystery is Christ among you, your hope of glory. This is the Christ we proclaim. This is the wisdom in which we thoroughly train everyone and instruct everyone to make them all perfect in Christ. It is for this I struggle wearily on, helped only by his power, driving me irresistibly. Yes, I want you to know that I do have to struggle hard for you, and for those in Laodicea, and for so many others who have never seen me face to face. It is all to bind you together in love and to stir your minds so that your understanding may come to full development until you really know God's secret, in which all the jewels of wisdom and knowledge are hidden. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
In God is my safety and glory. In God is my safety and glory. In God alone be at rest, my soul, for my hope comes from him. He alone is my rock, my stronghold, my fortress. I stand firm. In God is my safety and glory. Take refuge in God, all you people. Trust him at all times. Pour out your hearts before him, for God is our refuge. In God is my safety and glory. Alleluia, alleluia. Your word is a lamp for my steps and a light for my path. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And
with a reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. On the Sabbath, Jesus went into the synagogue and began to teach, and a man was there whose right hand was withered. The scribes and Pharisees were watching him to see if he would cure a man on the Sabbath.
hoping to find something to use against him. But he knew their thoughts, and he said to the man with the withered hand, "Stand up, come out into the middle." And he came out and stood there. Then Jesus said to them, "I put it to you, is it against the law on the Sabbath to do good or do evil, to save a life or destroy it?" Then he looked around at them and said to the man, "Stretch out your hand." He did so, and his hand was better. But they were furious and began to discuss the best way of dealing with Jesus. The Gospel of the Lord. We see in this morning's Gospel two different ways of looking at Jesus. We have the Pharisees and the officials who are looking at Jesus not for support, not for healing, and not for help, but rather looking at him to try and find a way to deal with him. Then we have those who are in need, the man with the withered hand, who is looking at Jesus for support, for love, for care. And in response, Jesus heals him with those simple words. The way in which we look at Jesus should be the same as the man with the withered hand, knowing that if we look upon the face of Christ, he will give us his support, his love, and his care.
So let us turn to the Lord with all our needs and petitions this day. We pray for the church, that it may always be a place where people find the love of Christ. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for our wars and its many ends. We pray that people may look towards peace rather than war. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for ourselves and our journeys of faith, that we may never doubt in God's loving presence. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For those who are sick in mind or in body, that they may find the healing presence and touch of Jesus. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For those who have died and those whose anniversaries occur at this time, for families who grieve and mourn the loss of their lives and friends, that they may be given comfort in the midst of them. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We ask for the prayers of Mary, Queen of Heavens, we pray to you.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
We make these and all our prayers through Jesus Christ, who is Lord forever and ever.
Amen. Thank you.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread, which earth has given and to your hands have made, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer. Through the divine work of your hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who give us the gifts of true prayer and of peace, graciously grant that through this offering we may do fitting homage to your divine majesty, and by partaking of the sacred mystery, we may be faithfully united in mind and heart, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For we know you have no need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving is itself your gift. Since our praises are nothing to your greatness, but profit us for salvation. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna. Brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection,
just invited for whom we offer this mass, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, Saint John the Baptist, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him, O God Almighty, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever. Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Love God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Love God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Now, God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lord.
Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall. Thank you. pray together for that spiritual union, and join with those who are still unable to join us physically from us. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament of the altar. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. And since many cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into their hearts. We embrace you as if you were there already, and unite ourselves wholly to you, never permitting us to be separated from you. Let us pray. Grant that your faithful, O Lord, whom you nourish and endow with life through the food of your word and heavenly sacrament, may so benefit from your beloved Son's great gifts, that we may merit an eternal share in his life, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is good.